We're going to look at Dr. Peyam's circle-parabola problem using just synthetic geometry, or at least as much as possible. So no calculus, not even any algebra. We're going to use the kind of arguments that your grandparents would have learned from Euclid. And here's how it goes. And if you clicked on the thumbnail because of the Latin, if that's why you're here, we'll get to that. But really, we start with a vertical line. So it's all about constructions. We choose a point F on that line, and then we draw a circle around F, and we'll call the upper point where that circle intersects our vertical line, we call that C. Now we draw another circle with C as our center that intersects point F. So now we've got two identical circles, and this is a construction which you would see in Euclid's first proposition. In that construction, we create an equilateral triangle. Now I'm going to try to draw as few of those segments as possible so we don't get really cluttered up here. Where our two circles meet, we'll call those points of intersection P and P prime. For now, let's just look at P because we're going to draw a third circle. That circle is going to go through C and F. So now we've got three equal circles, which we're going to say have a unit radius. That's how we're going to define our unit in this story. Just below P, where two circles intersect, we're going to call that point D and construct a horizontal line. And all of these constructions are ones that we could use using the principles of Euclidean construction, but we will not go into all of those details here. So now we'll take a look at what we've got. We've got point F and a line running underneath it. Let's call this lower point of intersection between our vertical line and that circle. We'll call it F prime. Now, do you see that the horizontal line, it runs right through the center of one of these equilateral triangles? It bisects that unit radius between F and F prime, meaning it's one half unit below F. So let's bisect that bisection. We'll find the midpoint between the horizontal line and point F, which is going to be a quarter of a unit below point F. And we're going to give a name to that point. We will call it V. So between C and V is by necessity 5/4 of a unit, just because of the way that we've constructed this. A parabola is the set of all points that have the same distance from a focal point, F, and a certain straight line, which is called the directrix. Now we're going to draw a parabola with F as the focus, V as the vertex, and that horizontal line as the directrix. Because PF and PD are equal in length, by necessity, that parabola must run through points P and P prime. So now we'll take away the baggage, and now we're left with Dr. Peyam's circle and parabola, where the circle touches the parabola at points P and P prime. Our question was basically how far is C from V? But we've shown that the distance between C, the center of that circle, and V, the vertex of that parabola, is 5/4. And that's the same units Dr. Peyam was using in his more analytic construction. This horizontal line, which runs through the focus between opposite points on the parabola, that is called the latus rectum. Okay? I hope you're satisfied. This line is the reason they stopped teaching this kind of geometry to pre-adolescent boys. But we're better than that, right? Bob is your uncle. Cheers.